There are many ways to live life. Would it not be better to live in a utopia, a heaven on earth type society? A society where all life is treated with respect? A society where every single human being on the face of the earth has access to education, clean water, food, shelter? There are enough resources to support a civilization of this quality. And what I've been postulating this entire series is that a civilization such as this existed before the end of the last ice age. A utopia-like society is possible with the current situation. The first step to the manifestation of that society is education. You see, when your mind becomes more knowledgeable about the nature of reality, the awareness expands to such a degree that it allows for critical thinking to take hold. It is this critical thinking that allows someone to understand the implications of information rather than just seeing information as random facts with no significant connection. Science, for example, allows critical thinking to take hold because science is simply the study of the nature of reality. It is the process of observing data to better understand the world around us. By reforming the entire educational system, as well as the very architecture in which the educational system's practices take hold, we would drastically affect the course of society, because all of society starts with the children. However, currently in our society, children are being placed in educational systems around the world that are not only outdated, but are structured in such a manner that kills the inquisitive nature of children. Not only that, but the structure of society itself generates people who snuff out the creative nature of the child. Noam Chomsky is an American linguist, philosopher, cognitive scientist, historian. He is a professor at MIT, and he's been pointing out the truths of our society for decades.
I quoted the Trilateral Commission view of the educational system, namely it's a system of indoctrination of the young. And I think that's correct. It's a system of indoctrination of the young. That was the way the liberal elites regard it, and they're more or less accurate. So the educational system is supposed to train people to be obedient, conformist, not think too much, do what you're told, stay passive, don't cause any crises of democracy, don't raise any questions. Even the fact that the system has a lot of stupidity in it, I think, has a function. If you can guarantee lots of stupidity in the educational system, you know, like stupid assignments and things like that, you know that the only people who make it through are people like me and like most of you, I guess, who are willing to do it no matter how stupid it is, because we want to go to the next step, you know. So you may know that this assignment is idiotic and the guy up there couldn't think his way out of a paper bag, but you'll do it anyway, because that's the way you get to the next class. And you want to make it, and so on and so forth. Well, there are people who don't do that, you know. There are people who say, I'm not going to do it, it's too ridiculous, you know. Those people are called behavioral problems, or something like that. They end up in the principal's office, or in the streets, or selling drugs, or whatever. And all of this is a technique for selection for obedience.
I believe that the rudimentary nature of our society is indeed a cancer to this earth. The earth being a living organism, and we being bacteria on the planet, unfortunately forming cancer clusters made of concrete and asphalt that spread on the earth's surface. The mindset of the masses is reflected in the physical manifestation of our cities. Our disconnect from nature is as literal as these images show. For a cancer cell is simply a cell that has disconnected itself from the body, multiplying itself over and over until the body dies. And all this begins with the children, because it is they who grow into the adults that carry on the ideologies of society. There's no reason why the elementary schools, the high schools, and the universities cannot be structured in the same manner of that of the Ontario Science Center, a free-range educational program, if you will, a structure that has each subject accessible to all the children at any given time. Each subject's classroom will have an interactive learning experience, so that the children's curiosity will be consistently stimulated, and thus making learning a fun experience. It is proven that structures that incorporate sacred geometry have an effect on human consciousness, elevating it to a certain degree. This is why the ancient Egyptians, for example, designed their civilization the way they did, a reflection of the heavens to earth, which also encompasses the earth's movements through the stars, monitoring the cycle of the solstices and the precession of the equinox. The sacred geometric numerology encoded within the structures are recognized by the supercomputer that is the subconscious mind. So redesigning the school buildings, for instance, into a glass geodesic dome would be a great way to elevate the consciousness of the child, having them exposed to the elements throughout the year while remaining safe within the dome building. You would have this dome building split into sections that are specified to each subject. Astronomy, for instance, will be taught by an interactive computer program that allows the children to study the galaxies and stars. The biology department would have the children learning about the origins of life via electromicroscopes and VR technology. The math department will be designed in a manner that incorporates both the logical and creative side of children. By the end of each day, the children will gather around in a circle with the teacher in the middle, and they will discuss what they learned that day. This elevated educational system will be the first step into creating a new type of human civilization, one that is focused on self-discovery and the exploration of the world around us. There is no reason why we cannot have education be as fascinating as it actually is. In fact, the educational system that we have now, it's almost like it's designed to dull the mind of a child. Alleged professionals in the educational system do not understand why the children are the way they are. Their narrow-minded thinking just leads itself to the conclusion that children are just disobedient and do not want to learn, which is complete horseshit, because children are the ones who ask why. Why? They want to know. It's the society, the schooling system, and the adults that literally snuff that out.
Children really want to know how the world works. The kids want to know everything, and we give them Jack and the Beanstalk and the Mickey Mouse Club. Kids really ready to learn how the body works. They want to know how the heart pumps blood through. Parents don't know those things. So when you say, should we educate our own children? You can't, unless you're educated yourself. You give kids Cinderella, artificiality, and you tell them to be honest. You always tell children to be honest. When they say, where do babies come from? The stork brings a baby. That's a lie. Then you ask the kids, say, Daddy, does Santa Claus climb down every chimney? You say, yes. That's a lie. And so we lie to kids, and then we tell them to be honest.
We are living in the most pivotal point of human history. I just want to make it clear for any mother out there that your actions and what you expose your child to is literally you deciding the direction that the species will take, one person at a time.
Take your part and function. We are not concerned with the divisions of segments of society.
No control of population?
Population control is dependent upon education. We feel an educated population needs no control.
You wouldn't stop sex?
No, sir.
Good move, Jacques.